It is time to break some laws. And we still have supply drops. Even every game has this now. Although, a lot of respect goes out to Bosky Productions for making these cosmetic only. We have been screwed so much by Call of Duty in the recent years. It is nice. Oh, we got a purple. Ooh, that's what I use too, the Harrier. That's the character I usually use. Equip on both. We have been screwed so much over the last few years with Call of Duty. It's nice to see a company understand that cosmetic only is the way to go and actually follow through with it. This is also on console, by the way. I know a lot of people, I don't know why, everyone thinks this is like Overwatch. I guess I haven't played Overwatch, but I don't really think it's Overwatch. Oh, purple again though, nice. Who's that for? The Titan. I don't use him, or I haven't used him yet. I spent a decent amount of time playing with Harrier. That's gonna be who I use because that's my main. But this is a game that's only $30. All the supply drop stuff is, or stash drops, is cosmetic only. And another thing on top of that is that all of the content in the future, when it comes to DLCs and maybe new characters added to the game, is free. It's not like Rainbow Six where they charge you for that. It's not like Call of Duty where they charge you for that. It's like not like every other game where they charge you. The method that they're using here, their whole business model is insane. All right, into the game with Harrier. This is the best character I could really come up with while playing at their beta. And it was a new character that was actually a lot of fun for me. And it's a lot of flying around. I think it's probably because I'm so used to that at this point. I think it's because I'm so used to that that now I just try to fly around a lot of the time. I have a Harrier as well, huh? Oh, gotta get away from the gunslinger. He's a scary man. We got him? Cool, cool, cool. Throw that in there for my team. Try to melt this guy. Robot dude, get him. No! They're all there still. They got a big tanky dude. That big robot guy is a super tank. Like, annoying as hell to kill. He's very slow movement though, unless you get really, really, really good with him. He's really not that quick. I might have to switch over to the Enforcer, who's a bit more reliable of a character in terms of damage. That's the tank guy. He just keeps activating his tank mode. That's really annoying. We're gonna go up on him though. We're okay, we're not gonna go into him. He's got a shotgun, so he's not a dude that you really want to challenge point blank. That sucks. He got all that armor. Got rid of him, though. We got the tank guy. Throw that for my teammates to heal them. Oh, I'm in trouble. He does more damage than I do. Sit here for a moment. Heal up. Gosh damn. Get away from me. Oh, I walked into the shotgun. Yeah. I walked into the shotgun there. This game's actually a lot of teamwork. It's really not a game that you can carry alone, I would say. Unless you are unbelievable. I'm not unbelievable. So maybe there is a level that I have not got to. Oh, ulti though. Oh, got it, boys. I'll try to help you. I can't really hit the guy. Shit! Get him all away! Get him all away! Get this tank bastard away from me! He's so annoying. If you can focus him down, it's not so bad. But man, he is so tanky against my character. It's really hard to challenge him. I don't know where the next hill spawn is. All right, this is kind of a good position for me. I'm gonna throw my boosts up here. I'll chase you down. I'm not letting you get away. Ah! Get away from him! Get away from him now! Get away from him! Team fire! Blew him away! I can't help you. I'm sorry. There we go. So I'm just gonna float up here the whole time. Because my character is one of the few that can really float around a lot. Like, aggressively fly. And I can chase down their Harrier which is what I should definitely be trying to do. I'm trying to help out with the tank guy. Yo, leave me alone, bro! Leave me alone! Get away! Oh, their enforcer guy, I think that was, just chased me down the whole time. He did not like me. He did not like me at all. I could try being the tank, I think. I don't know. What I want to do is I want to get above him right now. And help him out with the ulti. Get out of here, robot. Team up on this robot guy. I'll team up on this guy. That's the assassin, I think. He's super squishy. So if you can focus him really well, I am in trouble. Get down. Get away. There we go. There we go. We got away. Alright, we got some health. Okay, that's all team helping me there. Thank you, bros. Behind us? Maybe? Nope, we're okay right now. Okay, now we have a- Oh, we got a problem! Kill him! I'm trying to heal us! Teamwork, I like it, dude. Nice job. Dude was helping out. We were just chilling in here. Chilling like villains. Our spawn's over there, so we should be okay. I'm really low. I gotta heal up. There we go. I gotta remember to use my alt fire more often. Oh, I'm dead. Gunslinger point blank against my character. Dead 100% of the time. He's like a sniper, dude. But you gotta be really accurate with him. And if you miss, a lot of the times you can get punished for that. Unfortunately, at that range, you know, you don't miss too much. Alright, I gotta get around this thing really quick here. Oh, I'm dead. Shotgun tank guy again. I could've used my ulti right there, but I was scared doing it because it's not a great spot. It's hard to see them all. Strategic ultis. We're still doing great though. My character's not a big, like, slayer. Like assassin is or gunslinger. But it's a very good assist level player where... you want to be able to help your team out as much as you can. You don't want to get into the middle of the gunfight and try tanking everybody on your own. It's going to be a very difficult match if you do that. Alright, yeah, I'm not going to take that. I will take you, though. There we go. I didn't really want to use my whole ulti for that one guy. That was his ulti. Shit. It didn't push in, unfortunately. It looked like they were going to, and then he backed up and hid behind the wall. It was a good use of his little shield. He's so annoying to kill. I mean, he's a great character to just be a total annoying bastard. But you gotta have a really good team of slayers behind you to really follow up with that. Otherwise, you just don't do enough. Alright. If you wait till he uses his shield as well and you catch him when that's on cooldown, you can do okay. But, it's still difficult. When I see him, I gotta remember to use my alt fire, because I gotta really slow him down. Holy crap! Trying to heal. Oh, this dude's shooting little grenades at us! Well, he's missing a lot too, thankfully. Team on him, there you go, good job guys. That's what we gotta do right there. Team on that guy. Heal up again. They don't want to go in without their tank, who's now here. There we go. Alright, we gotta fly over the next zone. Keep that guy nice and full health. Now I gotta chill above him and float and abuse my floating advantage here. First to 200 points wins, so we're almost there. There we go. Yeah, we have two Harriers on our team. We're really abusing the fact that we can fly. Your ulti ain't gonna save you this time. I knew he was gonna come. Goal was just to keep him out. There we go. GG! That's more of like a headquarters style game, if you guys know that from COD at all. But I think my favorite game mode in this is Blitzball. Really like it the most. Assassin took number one. They usually do. They're heavy in the kill section. I did really good though for a team assist player. I'm sure I have 10 times more assists than the assassin guy, dude. He had 11 assists. I had 20. I had the least amount of deaths as well. So I did 13 and 7 with 20 assists. And that's what my character is. Harrier is a lot of high floating. You got to stay above other players. Lay down supportive fire if you can. I got the S rank with her. So, I mean, that's just how you play the character. If you get up close, you get murdered by those really like DPS dudes, the assassin and gunslinger. If you go up long range against the tanks, you can't do any damage to them. They got a billion health, a lot of armor. But the game's fun. And like I said, it's pretty cheap. $30 is all it is, along with free DLC forever. That's not bad at all. If you guys would like to try it, of course, link is in the description. But thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed some Lawbreakers. And you might see me playing this on stream soon. I will see you guys later.